Hello, and welcome to a new video here on my channel, here at commaik. In this video, I would like to briefly and concisely show you how you can easily register your Reolink cameras on your computer's client or in the app on your phone. If you want to know how this works, stay tuned because that's exactly what this video is about. I will show you how to set up the cameras on the client on the computer and in the phone app. Using a WLAN camera, namely the Reolink Altis WLAN battery camera, and I'll show you how it works with a wired Reolink Elite X Pro PoE camera. I have already been able to test both cameras. If you're interested in the cameras, take a look in the top right corner. There I will link you to the videos about the cameras. Now I would like to start with the PoE variant. With the Reolink Elite X Pro PoE, the power supply is ensured here via the network cable, and of course the data is also transmitted. In order to integrate the camera into the network, I need a network cable. The cable is included in delivery, however, not always in the right length. The cable is simply plugged into the network socket. You plug the other half into the router or switch on your network. The special feature of a PoE camera is that the power is supplied via the normal network cable. This means, if you want to use this function, the device on the other side must of course feed in the power. For this you need a PoE switch or a PoE injector. You can see exactly what that is if you look at the description under the video. I'll link some information there for you. Once the camera is connected to it, it will turn on automatically. On some models, you first have to switch on the camera manually on the bottom or back. If it is switched on, you can continue directly on the computer. As soon as I have connected the camera to the network cable and it is booted up, it automatically appears at the bottom of the list in the client and just needs to be logged in. If it doesn't appear automatically for you, you have the option to add the camera manually using plus. The cameras that the system finds in your network are displayed in the UID area. Here you can add the camera directly using the plus. Alternatively, you can of course also specify the IP address of the camera. You can usually find the IP address in your router. If neither of these work, then the camera is not registered correctly in the network, or your router is blocking the camera in some way. To register the camera, I click on the tile, and I have to assign a password. By default, this area is empty. Important for all of you who have a network video recorder, an NVR, running on your network. With the latest software updates, the NVR automatically assigns a start password when it detects a new camera. You first have to adjust this start password directly on the NVR screen with the mouse or Reddit there, and then enter it here. I have already done this and will now enter the password in the password capture from the client. I then confirm the entry. Then I immediately see the live image from the camera. Of course, you can also use the same procedure in the app. I have already started the Reolink app and am in the camera overview. At the bottom of the overview, the most recently added cameras are automatically displayed to me. In my case, also the Reolink Elite X Pro PoE. Of course, the camera is not registered yet. Here you have the plus at the top, right to register the camera manually. You can of course also use the QR code scanner to scan the camera's QR code at this point, and thus establish a quick connection. Alternatively, you can manually enter the UID code that is on the camera. Or you can scan your network for the cameras that the system has automatically found. In my case, I don't need this. The camera was added automatically. I click on the tile and have to enter the password here too. I confirm the entry, and shortly afterwards the live image from the camera is displayed to me. I can now adjust the camera settings, just like it works on the client. So you can see that setting up the PoE camera is very easy. If you have any questions about it, write me a comment below the video. I'll try to answer as quickly as possible. Now let's move on to the second camera. Namely this Wi-Fi camera, the Reolink Altis. Unfortunately, With WLAN cameras, it is not that easy to integrate them directly into the network because there are two variants here too. In one variant, the cameras also have a breakout cable and must first be connected to the system using a network cable. The access data for the WLAN can then be set up with the client. This means it works just like a PoE camera. You connect the camera to the network cable on your router or switch. Then start the client or app and enter the password. Then you switch to the network settings. Then find your WLAN and enter the network password. Now you can basically access the camera via Wi-Fi. This Reolink battery power camera no longer has a cable installed. On the bottom, I only have the connection for the USB power supply or the option to insert an SD card. In order to integrate this camera into my network, I absolutely need the app on my phone and the QR code printed on the camera. I'll now show you how you can easily integrate the camera into your network by starting the app. As soon as the app has started, click on the plus in the top right and take a photo of the QR code that is on the camera. As soon as the camera has been recognized, the system asks how and what you want to connect the camera to. I have the Home Hub and Home Hub Pro installed on my network and could connect the camera directly to either device. But I won't do that in this video and will integrate the camera as a standalone device. Of course, it is also possible to link it to the Home Hub or Home Hub Pro later. You can also link the powered Wi-Fi cameras to the NVR. Since the WLAN has not yet been configured, I take the first option and link the camera to my network via the Bluetooth function. Of course, this must be switched on your phone. Illustrated instructions now show me exactly what I have to do. I first have to turn the camera on using the power button. Welcome to Reolink. Please install the Reolink app and scan the QR code on the camera. After I scan the surroundings using Bluetooth and confirm in the app that I heard the very loud announcement, I am automatically redirected to the WLAN setup. Here I can select the preferred WLAN and enter the password for this WLAN. After the device has been registered on the WLAN, I have to assign a password and confirm it again. The camera is then available to me directly in my app, and by clicking on the tile, I am in the settings and can use the camera. The settings menu is also available to me here, and I can fine-tune it. After I have integrated the camera into my network, I would of course also like to use it on the client on my computer. I restarted the client. This time the camera was not automatically added to the list. In that case, I choose the plus. I'm looking for the devices that have already been discovered on the network. Here, scroll down to the camera that has been recognized. You have to make sure that the name of the camera is not always displayed. For me, the name is My Device. The camera is now integrated via the plus. Here too, I have to enter the password. And you can see that the camera is now registered in my client. I see that there is no SD card installed yet, and that the WLAN has very good reception. The battery level is also displayed. Here too, I can adjust the camera settings via the menu. For example, I can adjust the video stream. I hope I was able to show you how quickly and easily you can integrate a wired or Wi-Fi camera into your network. Do you want to know more? For example, how fine-tuning in the settings works. Would you like to know how to unlock the camera so that you can access the camera with your mobile data on the go? Then look below the video. There I will link you to my other videos in which I explain this in detail. Feel free to write me a comment under the video so that we can exchange ideas with each other. Reolink sponsors the cameras. Check out the video below. There you will find the promo link and can buy the cameras. I'll also link you to the other products that I'm happy with and would happily recommend. Give me a like for my video and subscribe to my channel. Remember, with your subscription, you have the chance to win one of the cameras I get from Reolink. You heard right. These cameras are drawn in regular competitions. If you want to be there, subscribe to my channel. Until the next video, I'm looking forward to it. Take care. Until then, bye.